Hi, I'm Linda. I'm painting roses today. Thought you might like to follow along. So we're going to begin with a blank piece of sandblasted milk glass. I'm going to load my brush in my off-white, because these are going to be a pink and off-white rose. So I'm edging it to get a little bit of the pink on my brush. And I'm going to line up where I want to begin. I'm going to begin at this inward part of the silver crest. Do my bowl. And sandblasted pieces really hang on to the paint because it's porous, where a slick, shiny piece is not. So I will have to load my brush more often. Mostly dipping into the darker color because the light color is my base. And I'm accenting it with a darker color. So there's one. I'm going to rinse my brush a little bit. Reload in the off-white. Okay, now I'm going to turn it this way because I want to do one in the other direction. And I didn't get enough pink, so I'm going to do it again. That's a little better. I lost my color there, so I'm going to do it again. And if I don't like that in the end, I will take it off.
I noticed when we were looking at the end of your piece, you've already signed it. Is there a reason you sign them all at the same time?
I sign it usually first so that I don't have to then touch the glass as much to sign it after it's painted. Okay, we're going to let that one stand for a minute, see if I like it, if it lines up. So I'm going to turn my piece again. I'm going to try to get one on this side. See if I can get some balance, which is not always easy. I'm going to reload my base, tip my brush in the red, and start out with the petals and see how they flow. Running out. I'm going to do it again. So that first one's a little bit weak, so I'm going to add a little bit to it. And I'm going to add my center, which is that squiggly S. And then a center there. So that's pretty balanced. So I'm going to let that stand for now. We'll see. And on the back, I'm going to see where I am here so I can get my middle. So I'm going to come across. Usually you can take this as a reference point and think about where it would end up over here. Hold it with your finger, turn it. And over here, I'm just gonna put a couple of buds because this is a small piece. I don't wanna overwhelm it. And then I'm gonna see if I lined up from there to there. Looks like I'm pretty good. So we're gonna let that one dry. I'll go on to the next one. After I do a few of these, I'll go back and do green. So I'm reloading my brush. If I get it too wet, I'll wipe it off on the paper towel so I don't end up with a lot of turpentine in it. See, this one's signed on the bottom, so I will go ahead and do the decoration. I'll put my rose on here because these are for the Rosie group. And the rose indicates the Rosie group. Okay, I really have nothing in my head at this point, so I'm just going to kind of wing this. I think I'll do a bud up here because this is going to be difficult to get my hand in. I'm going to set it down and pick it up a lot. Okay, I'm going to put buds around three sides. And then I'm not going to do this side yet because I want to be able to get my hand inside. So inside, I'm probably going to put one rose. This is where it gets tricky. Oh, there, I've got a hair on my brush. So I'm going to rinse that hair out. My turpentine. Check my brush. And I see that hair, so I'm going to get that off there. That's the nice thing about brushes. You can pull those hairs out when they fall. And natural bristle brushes, which these are, do shed. Okay, I'm going to come on this side. I'm going to fix that other side because I didn't really like it. A little more paint. This brush is giving me a little trouble. I don't know whether it's the paint or the brush. We will find out. This one again. I'm going to come up from the bottom. Add two little ones right there. And that center squiggly S goes right in there. And then the little centers. Okay, and I'm going to go around and do those other buds. See if I can get the buds all around. Okay, so I'm going to set that over here. We're going to come back to this piece. I'm going to change color. I'm going to go to green. So I use this light green. I have more here if I need it. Ready to go. This light green is pretty much all used up, but I won't need that much here. So I'm not going to take the time to mix all of this chunky green in there.
So can you revitalize your paint by putting a little more of the solvents in it on a regular basis?
Yes. Yeah, if I add more of that chunky part, I'll be adding a little more pigment.
So I've noticed one of the biggest skills is knowing when to put a little more turp in and when to put a little more oil in.
Right. You use a lot less oil than you do turpentine. Okay. Green. I'm going to pick this brush. This is a little bit smaller. Get it wet in the turpentine. Wipe it off so I don't have leaky. I don't want it to leak on the palette. And if I think it's too thin, I will come over here where it's kind of dried out a little bit. This is my first load. These are two colors blended. And then I'll go over here to the light, or dark, from the light, and I'm going to edge. Okay, now I got to watch I don't stick my fingers in it. And these are just going to be little leaves to accent those roses. I always look where my pinky's been, too, because if I stick my pinky in my palette, it's going to end up right there. So a little bit of green here and there, just to kind of case those roses, like framing them.
Boy, that really makes them pop when you get the leaves on there.
Mm-hmm. It does. And these are small leaves, and mostly these are one-stroke leaves, where I do two-stroke leaves a lot of the time. On a bigger piece. Okay, now we're going to go over here and get these buds. Give them just a little bit of green. And I'll go ahead and give them a little bit down here. Somewhere for that stem to go. going to lay that down because I'm going to use it again. And I'm going to do a few stems. I need it to be thin. I'm using a real thin scroller. I load it really well. I'm turning it, loading it, making it thin. If it's too thick, I'll get a little turpentine and then pull some more paint back out. Okay, so I'm going to add a little stem here. Hopefully my brush will work well. You never know until you lay it down. Once you lay your brush down on your glass, it's like, hello. Are we working today? Yes, we are.
So sometimes they give you a little surprise?
Many times. Okay, I'll probably add a little more to that here in a second. Okay, this is going to be my stems. They're going to come out over here. And then I got to do the rose hairs, as I always call them. I want those to be thin. Little rose hairs. And as I said before, everybody does these differently. I like mine to be thin, and I like them to be noticeable.
I know I've heard you say sometimes that some of the painting you've looked at, people just have leaves flying in the air.
Yeah.
And you don't go for that.
I don't go for that. I'm going to let a little bit of a stem come down here. And if this wasn't sandblasted, I could do this with my pen point. But I can't do it with my pen point on sandblasted. It's too porous and rough.
So would it pull more paint out of the pen point than you would like? Or?
No, the pen point won't write very well on sandblasted glass. I had a hard time getting my name on. Okay. I'm going to move over to this piece. Add some green. And see what we have, and this won't necessarily stay as the finished product since I'm kind of not sure where I want to go yet. We'll see what happens. These will be two-stroke leaves because I want a big leaf. So I've got two colors, light green and dark green. Okay, now I'm going to go back to the smaller leaves, put those right here. One stroke, and I'm going to put a third leaf here, just because.
You know, I think watching you do all these details fills in some of the gaps, because I know when you sell things online, it's hard to see the details. I think people don't understand how many strokes and parts there are to your flowers.
Very possible. And these buds are going to have just the little bit of green underneath them and a stem. And then on these pieces, I will add the blue forget-me-nots. See, I forgot what they were. They're forget-me-nots. Okay, stems. I think I got thin enough. Let me check. One, there's paint in there. A little turpentine. My paint's going, nope, not coming out. There we go. Yes, I am here. And this one said I might be here. Okay, this one said very bold. Let's see what we're gonna get with this one. Ooh, a little thinner. Okay, well, that's all right. Okay, we need to attach these little leaves. Sometimes I like to make them squiggly. I'm not going to put a long stem on there because I'm just going to add the blue flowers on there and then the dots. Okay. We'll go back to this one. Let's see what we want to do here. Might do a different position. I'm almost out of this color. I'm gonna have to add this color. I think it's a little lighter. But this has had pink dipped into it too. So that makes a difference.
So this would kind of indicate how everything has a little bit of difference from one piece to the other, unless you're doing them production style.
Oh, production style. Sometimes I still use that method. If I'm doing like 10 or 12 of the same thing, I use production style. Okay, I'm gonna go to a big brush. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do here, but see the difference?
Yep.
If I don't like what this does, I'll go back to this. Uh-oh, what is that? That's a little bug. Oh my goodness. I bet he wishes he didn't do that.
Away with the bug.
I was careful. Okay, dipping in the pink. This might be really wild. Because I got a big brush here. So I'm going to try to see if I can get more than one on here. With the big brush, it goes further. Turn it. Oh, I need to do this side. Okay. Gotta reload. Do the off-white. Make it in there pretty thick. If I get too much turp, I'm gonna blot it out. Then I'm gonna load the pink. Let's see if we can squeeze one in here with this big brush. I gotta get my hand out of the way. So far, so good. Sometimes a big brush is better than a little brush.
Why is that?
Well, it holds more paint. And like I was running out of paint with that little brush, and I kept having to do it over and over. This one holds more. But I also have a tendency to really paint big with a big brush, and I run out of room. And this is a small, like a nut dish or a little bowl. I don't know what they're called, actually. But these were sandblasted because when we bloomed them in the kiln, they got all kinds of dark stuff on it that you can't help. It just happens sometimes when you bloom the glass. So these were sandblasted, and look at the crest, how it turned out. I think it's beautiful.
Oh, yeah, it is.
It's different. So when you don't sandblast it, and you just bloom it in the kiln, this is what the crest looks like. And it's kind of cool looking, but look at the difference. This is like snow.
Good for the season.
This is like ice.
We sure know about snow this winter, don't we?
Okay, buds. I'm going to put these buds kind of different. I'm going to lay them in the side. Like that. Where those I stuck straight up.
Mm-hmm.
These I'm going to lay in the sides. Got to get my fingers out of my way. And just kind of come around.
So everybody has a clue as to the effort that goes into these. So this piece has been fired one time, then sandblasted.
Sandblasted because it bloomed funny.
Yeah. And you're painting the first load of paint on it.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you get all of the decoration done, it will be fired again.
Mm-hmm.
And each fire takes approximately 2 hours and 15 minutes to get up to temperature.
Mm-hmm.
And then we use at least 5 to 6 hours bare minimum to let it cool.
Mm-hmm.
And part of that is hands-on time watching to make sure that everything is working correctly.
Yeah, I have to watch the cone. I can't just walk away. Okay, we got buds. Okay, green. So hopefully my green is still fairly moist. It does dry up quickly. Okay. I'll start in here. This is going to be tight. And there's a hair on there, so we'll see what happens here. It comes out. Uh-oh, may have to mix. Uh-oh. I hit that bump. I hit the bump in the glass.
Bump in the glass?
Right there. I have a bump. See the bump comes around?
Oh, okay.
Okay. Okay, we're going to finish this green and then get those stems on there. And I think that'll probably do it for right now. I got to mix my blue and everything, and that just takes a while. So to get it just right, fix that. Little petals. I call them petals, but they're leaves. Little leaves. Stems. I'm going to just go around like this. Then I'll come back. And then I'll do my rose hairs. Get this little guy here. Okay. Rose hairs. Get back in there. Another one. One more. Okay, now I gotta get over here and get this stem. Little rose hairs, little stem. I didn't do that on here, did I? No. Little rose hairs, little stem, less room. What do I get over here? Okay. So we got three pieces with four colors. Two in the roses, two in the green, and the leaves. And the next thing I'm going to do is the blue forget-me-nots and the dots for next time.